Imagine this. You are sitting at the dinner table with your family, and you look around and notice your father has a pained look on his face, then suddenly collapses. Would you know what to do? This example shows exactly why it is so important for people to know the major steps of CPR in case of an emergency. I know CPR because I was required to take a first aid and CPR training course to become a lifeguard for my summer job. In my class, I learned that it is not your job to treat a person's illness, but it is your responsibility to help keep a victim alive until medical professionals arrive at the scene. Over the next few minutes, I will demonstrate to you how to perform the four major steps of CPR on an adult. The first step is to assess the scene and the person. In any emergency, the first step is to make sure that both you and the victim are safe. You need to check for safety hazards such as chemical spills, electrical wires, or gas fumes. Once you have assessed the scene, check the person. You should tap the person on the shoulder and shout, "Are you okay?" If the victim gives no response, you should immediately call for help. Next, you need to make sure that someone gets a hold of 911 and, of course, comes back to help the victim. Tell a bystander to call 911. Tell another bystander to get the AED if one's available. If there are no bystanders, it's up to you to get a hold of 911 and come back to help the victim. Next, check the victim for signs of breathing. Place your ear close to the victim's mouth and listen for signs of breathing for no longer than 10 seconds. Then, scan the victim's entire body for any signs of movement, especially in the chest area. If there are no signs of breathing, you must initiate CPR. Now that we are ready to perform CPR, get out a mouth guard if you have one. Mouth guards were made to help prevent illness to the rescuer when performing CPR on a victim. To perform CPR, you will use a cycle of 30 compressions and 2 breaths. To perform compressions, you will place your hands in the center of the victim's chest with one on top of the other, like so, and you must press at least 2 inches deep. One helpful hint for performing compressions is to press the victim to the beat of the 1980s pop tune, Stayin' Alive. This will help you stay in the correct tempo. When performing rescue breaths on a person without a mouth guard, you will tilt the victim's head, pinch their nose shut, and place your mouth over the victim's mouth. To perform CPR with the mouth guard, you will tilt the victim's head, put the mouth guard over the victim's nose and mouth, pressing slightly to get a good seal. I will now demonstrate one cycle of how to perform CPR on an adult. Notice how the victim's chest rose. If the victim's chest did not rise, you need to stop performing CPR because this probably means that they are choking. You will need to reposition the victim's head to look into their mouth and throat for any objects. If there is an object in their mouth or throat, use a one-finger sweep to remove the object. Then you will continue the cycle of 30 compressions and 2 breaths until the victim shows signs of life or a medical professional arrives at the scene. That was how do you perform the four major steps of CPR on an adult. Only about 46% of people get the help they need before medical professionals arrive in the event of a cardiac arrest. I hope that by this demonstration, you will feel a little bit more ready to help if someone were in need of CPR near you. Thank you for listening and have a great evening.